Following the French Revolution and the Napoleonic Wars, new ideas started to spread around the Habsburg monarchy, including Hungary. Inspired by the Enlightenment and Romanticism, Pest became a fascinating center of Hungarian reform movement and nationalism in the beginning of the 19th century, while Buda remained a sleepy old royal city, a symbol of oppression. The seat of the parliament was still in Pozsony, today Bratislava in Slovakia, and the official language of administration was Latin and German. King and Emperor Francis I was forced to call for the convention of the Hungarian Diet, as the parliament was called back then. The so-called reform period gave rise to rapid economic and civic development. The Hungarian parliament assembled again in 1825 to address financial matters. Some prominent aristocrats, such as Count István Széchenyi, recognized the urgent need for modernization. The Hungarian Academy of Sciences and a series of other new institutions were established in this period. Besides reform ideas, the construction of the first permanent stone bridge over the Danube was also initiated and promoted by István Széchenyi. The bridge was designed by the English engineer William Tierney Clark, and it opened for public use in 1849. The newly emerged Liberal Party focused its politics on the socio-economic situation and rights of the peasantry and laborers' needs. Another significant politician, Lajos Kossuth, emerged in the parliament as leader of the lower gentry. In order to preserve Hungary's traditional agricultural role in their imperial structure, the Habsburg monarchs tried to hinder industrialization in the country. Many reformers and intellectuals were imprisoned for their anti-Habsburg views. In the spring of 1848, following the rebellions in Paris and Vienna, a protest was mounted in Pest by young intellectuals, such as the famous poet Sándor Petőfi, and turned into a revolution on the 15th of March. Demand for major reforms was articulated by the list of the 12 demands, including the reunion of Hungary with Transylvania, more independence for the country, amnesty for political prisoners, and the shift of the Hungarian parliament from Pozsony to the twin cities of Pest Buda. The parliament took advantage of the revolution in Pest and adopted the so-called April Laws, which included dozens of civil rights reforms. The monarch Ferdinand V, facing instability and threat to his power both in Austria and Hungary, accepted the demands. The first independent government of Hungary, led by Count Lajos Batthyány, was set up with Prince Esterházy, Ferenc Deák, Lajos Kossuth, and other prominent aristocrats and politicians in their ranks. But as soon as the monarchy's political power had been stabilized, the Austrian chancellery, along with influential members of the imperial and royal family, decided to remove Ferdinand from power, as he was claimed to be mentally disabled and incapable of ruling the empire. Under the influence of his cabinet and his mother, the new emperor Franz Joseph replaced his uncle Ferdinand on the throne and rejected all the reforms signed by Ferdinand. Austria began to take up arms against Hungary, and the War of Independence broke out. The court used ethnic minorities living within the borders of Hungary against Hungarians by making them promises about rights and independence. Croatian, Serbian, and Romanian peasants, led by nationalist politicians and priests, remained loyal to the Habsburgs, while Hungarians were supported by the vast majority of the Slovaks and Rusyns, even Germans living in the country, and Jews. A huge number of Polish, Austrian, and Italian volunteers who had fought in the previous independent movements all around the empire joined the Hungarian army. One of them was the famous Polish general Józef Bem. In July of 1849, the Hungarian parliament adopted the most progressive ethnic and minority rights in the world. The move delayed the disaster coming, but proved too late to prevent it. In the glorious spring of 1849, the Hungarian army, called Honvédség, or National Defense Force in English, won a series of victories against the Austrian armies. The House of Habsburg was dethroned in the Hungarian part of the Austrian Empire, and Lajos Kossuth became governor and president of the country, while Debrecen was chosen as capital for the time being, since Pozsony, Pest and Buda were all under Austrian occupation. It seemed Austria could not deal with the situation, and Hungary would win the war. In his need, Franz Joseph asked for the help of the Russian Tsar Nicholas I. In June, Transylvania was invaded by Russian troops from the east, while the Austrian armies marched from the west. Hungarian forces were overwhelmed by the two armies together, and, disobeying Kossuth's orders, General Arthur Görgey surrounded in August 1849. The Austrian Marshal, Julius Freiherr von Haynau, was then appointed governor of Hungary, bearing absolute power. On the 6th of October, Haynau ordered the execution of 13 leaders of the Hungarian army, who are remembered in Hungarian folklore and memory as the 13 martyrs of Arad. Prime Minister Batthyány was executed in Pest. The governor, Lajos Kossuth, escaped into exile, and until his death he looked on Görgey's surrender as betrayal. After the fall of the War of Independence, life in Hungary was overshadowed by decades of tyranny. Acting against the centuries-old Hungarian constitutional rights, Franz Joseph incorporated Hungary into the empire on the same level as Austrian provinces, although he had not even been crowned King of Hungary. But his power remained unstable, since he lost significant territories as a result of the Italian unification. He lost his influence and dominance in the realm with Prussia, for the leadership of the Great German Unity likewise. In order to preserve the integrity of his remaining empire, Franz Joseph implemented constitutional reforms and granted more rights to the provinces. But he had to realize that without compromise with Hungarians there is no future for the Habsburg monarchy. He made an equitable deal with Hungary in 1867, the so-called Austro-Hungarian Compromise, which on Hungarian side was negotiated by the excellent statesman Ferenc DeThat was the official birth of the dual monarchy of Austria-Hungary, or the Austro-Hungarian Empire. The two realms were governed separately from its two capitals, Vienna and Budapest, by two independent parliaments, with a common monarch, within the frame of personal union, with common foreign and military policies. Economically speaking, the empire was a custom union. The first prime minister of Hungary after the compromise was Count Gyula Andrássy. The old Hungarian constitution was restored, and Franz Joseph and his wife Elizabeth were crowned King and Queen of Hungary in the Matthias Church in Buda. In 1868, Hungarian and Croatian assemblies concluded the internal Croatian-Hungarian compromise, which granted Croatia special rights in the empire as a country belonging to the Hungarian crown, yet enjoying autonomy and independence from Hungary. Austria-Hungary was the second largest nation in Europe by territory after Russia, and the third most populous one after Russia and the German Empire. The newly born Budapest became one of the most beautiful modern cities of the world, a center of industry as well as culture, attracting crowds from all over the Kingdom of Hungary, keen on starting a new life in the city. Around the turn of the 20th century, Budapest was one of the most populous cities on the globe. An especially important year for Hungarians was 1896, when the millennium, the 1000th anniversary of the Magyar conquest of the Carpathian Basin, was celebrated, culminating with the monumental millennial exhibition and inducing major urban improvements. The Austro-Hungarian Empire, as one of the world's great powers, had considerable influence on European and world politics, especially by taking part in the partition of the former Ottoman territories in the Balkans. Following the occupation and annexation of Bosnia, the empire had to face new internal conflicts on top of the already existing ethnic problems, such as the fast-growing Pan-Slavism supported by Russia, or the anger of Czechs because of being overwhelmed and excluded from the compromise and the re-establishment of the empire. As the heir, Archduke Franz Ferdinand was assassinated in Sarajevo by Gavrilo Princip, a Serbian nationalist, on the 28th of June 1914, while he was visiting the province Bosnia. Austria-Hungary demanded that Serbia allow them to investigate the crime. Since the request was denied, the monarchy declared war on Serbia, which was followed by Russia, the German Empire, Italy, the United Kingdom, France, the Ottoman Empire, the United States, and many other nations entering the conflict. The Great War, or as it is called now, the First World War, broke out, changing the history of mankind forever as the bloodiest and most global conflict ever. Austria-Hungary, together with the German Empire, Turkey, and others, formed the Central Powers, fighting against the coalition of the so-called Entente, which comprised France, the United Kingdom, the Russian Empire, Italy, and others. Franz Josef died in November of 1916. He was followed on the throne by his nephew, with the name Charles I, the last king of Hungary. 1917 brought serious changes in the balance of the war. Russia withdrew from the war after the Bolshevik takeover, but the United States joined the Entente. By the summer of 1918, the final collapse of German, Austrian, and Hungarian military forces were near on all fronts, and eventually they laid down their arms in November. During the four-year war, a total of 9 million soldiers were deployed in the monarchy, including 3.4 million from Hungary and Croatia. Out of 3.4 million people, 530,000 were killed on the battlefield, 1.4 million were injured, and more than 830,000 were taken prisoners. Hungary suffered the heaviest casualties on the Eastern and the Italian fronts. The Austro-Hungarian Empire collapsed, and the Habsburgs found themselves dethroned in both Austria and Hungary shortly after. Negotiations on a new world order started in Paris and the neighboring Versailles. Hungary and other defeated countries were not invited to take part until the final texting of the treaties. The peace treaty with Hungary was signed on the 4th of June 1920 at the Trianon Palace in Versailles. As a result, the area of the Kingdom of Hungary was reduced from 282,000 square kilometers to 93,000 square kilometers, to only the third of its original size. Its population was reduced from 18.2 million to 7.6 million, which is a 43% loss. Romania received the largest area, 103,000 square kilometers, which was bigger than the remaining Hungarian territories. Transylvania and Partium, with a population of more than 5 million, including almost 2 million Hungarians, became part of Romania. The newly born Czechoslovakia annexed 61,000 square kilometers of the Upper Hungarian territories, including the former royal capital Pozsony, which was renamed Bratislava. As addition to Croatia Slavonia, originally an autonomous region, the newly emerged Kingdom of the Serbs, Croats and Slovens, the future Yugoslavia, took 20,000 square kilometers, including Vojvodina and the Mura region. In order to avoid its union with Germany, even Austria was given some territories. 4,000 square kilometers of western Transdanubia would form the future Austrian province Burgenland. Poland and Italy also received a few square kilometers of the historical Hungarian territories. The Great War put an end to the Golden Age. Hungary was made a much smaller country by the Treaty of Trianon. A socialist democratic revolution, the declaration of the First Republic, and the presidency of Count Mihály Károly were soon to be followed by a short-lived communist dictatorship and terror, the so-called Republic of the Councils, as well as the occupation of the country by the Romanian army, which was eventually broken with the restoration of the kingdom under the leadership of the former Austro-Hungarian admiral Miklós Horthy. Hungary was made a kingdom without a king, with Horthy acting as regent. The following era was characterized by his conservative Christian views and revisionist aspirations, as well as his efforts to make Hungary visible on the world map again, collecting new allies and supporters to regain the lost territories. In 1938, following the first Vienna Award, by the help of Nazi Germany and its Führer Adolf Hitler, significant parts of Czechoslovakia, including Transcarpathia, were reclaimed. 2 years later, in 1940, a part of Transylvania was also returned by the Second Vienna Award, and later, parts of Vojvodina and the Mura region too. Meanwhile, Hungary faced growing anti-Semitism. Anti-Jew laws were adopted, such as the Numerus Clausus, which limited the number of people from certain groups of society in state offices, cultural and scientific life, and higher education. In 1940, the government affiliated Hungary with the Tripartite Pact, joining Nazi Germany and Fascist Italy. By that time, the Second World War had already been in full swing for 3 years, and Hungary had resisted entering, but eventually did. The country joined Germany in the war on the 1st of July 1941 and declared war first on the Soviet Union, then on other Allied powers as well. The following years, after initial successes, demanded huge sacrifices from Hungary on the Eastern Front. As the war progressed, Horthy lost more and more power and the country fell under direct influence of the Germans. Hungary's Jewish population was forced to move to ghettos, and later on, the vast majority of them were killed in Nazi concentration camps like Auschwitz-Birkenau. The destruction of the Hungarian Second Army, fighting in the Donbass region in the Soviet Union, was a catastrophic loss of nearly 360,000 soldiers in 1943. In autumn of 1944, as Hitler ordered the occupation of Hungary and the deportation of his former ally Regent Horthy, the far-right Hungarian Arrow Cross Party, supported by the German troops, seized power. But the end was near. The Soviet Red Army entered the country in 1945, as Hitler declared that Budapest was a fort to defend to the very end. The once shiny and wealthy city ended up being destroyed in a siege. The war in Europe ended on the 9th of May 1945, but the consequences were disastrous for the entire nation. An estimated 40% of national wealth was destroyed. Hundreds of thousands of people were killed in the war and by the Holocaust. Others got interned in concentration camps by the Soviets. As the Germans were declared as collectively guilty of war crimes, hundreds of thousands of Hungarian Germans were forced to leave their homeland forever. By the Treaty of Paris in 1947, Hungary lost all of the reclaimed territories once again. At the same time, Czechoslovakia deported Hungarians from the former Hungarian territories in exchange for ethnic Slovaks living in Hungary. Decision was made in Yalta about Hungary becoming part of the Soviet satellite zone behind the Iron Curtain. Although the Second Republic was established in 1946 and the country had a democratic leadership, the Soviets, using Hungarian communists as their puppets, exerted influence on the government to manipulate democratic operation. In the parliamentary election of August 1947, the communists committed widespread election fraud with absentee ballots. On the 18th of August 1949, the parliament passed the new Hungarian constitution, which was modeled after the constitution of the Soviet Union. The name of the country changed to People's Republic of Hungary, the country of workers and peasants, where every authority is held by the working people. A new coat of arms with communist symbols such as the Red Star, Hammer and Sickle was adopted instead of the historical symbols of the nation. The following years belong to the darkest chapters of the history of Hungary. During the Stalinist dictatorship of Mátyás Rákosi, in the early 50s, almost 2,000 people were executed and over 100,000 were imprisoned and about 44,000 of them ended up in labor camps. Many died due to horrible conditions. Another 15,000 people, mostly former aristocrats, industrialists, military generals, and other upper-class people were deported from the capital and other cities to poor countryside villages, where they were forced to do hard agricultural work. With an extensive nationalization program, the state gained control over most of the economy. All of the large and mid-sized companies, plants, mines, and banks. Rákosi's dream was to make Hungary a country of iron and steel, even though Hungary did not possess much iron ore. On the 22nd of October 1956, students of the Budapest University of Technology summarized their demands in 16 points, and the following day they organized a demonstration in solidarity with the Polish strikers in Poznan. Their points included the withdrawal of Soviet troops from Hungary, the formation of a new government led by the reform communist Imre Nagy, democratic elections, freedom of opinion and speech, and the free radio. On the 23rd of October, the peaceful demonstration turned into a mass uprising within less than an hour. During the night, protesters occupied the headquarters of the Hungarian radio and Free People, the journal of the party. The hated symbol of oppression, Budapest giant statue of Stalin, was demolished. The Soviet-like coat of arms was cut out of national flags and the flag with a hole in the middle became the symbol of the revolution and heroic fight for freedom. Imre Nagy became prime minister and declared a peaceful transition to democracy. On the 25th of October, in front of the parliament on Kossuth Square, Soviet tanks opened fire on the protesting crowd from the surrounding buildings. Fights started all around the city and the country and culminated in a short-lived victory of freedom fighters. Since the rest of the world was preoccupied with the ongoing Suez Crisis in Egypt, the Soviets managed to defeat Hungary without intervention by the West. On the 4th of November, the Red Army occupied Budapest and the resistance was crushed within days. The state power was taken by the Soviet-backed government of János Kádár, a traitor to the revolution. Almost 200,000 people immigrated from Hungary to Western countries. Prime Minister Imre Nagy was captured and executed. Revenge for the revolution was dreadful. However, the following decades brought the nation a softer but still oppressive communist dictatorship, slowly opening the country to the West. People in Hungary enjoyed a relatively good quality of life compared to other satellite states behind the Iron Curtain, even though the system had been reformed in 1968 with the introduction of new economic and cultural policies. The prospect of the end of the system was becoming more and more apparent. Parallelly to the collapse of the Soviet Union and the entire socialist world, some fundamental changes started in Hungary too. In 1989, the parliament gradually adopted new laws defining the framework for democratic transition. Opposition forces formed the Opposition Roundtable, which, together with the ruling party, formed the National Roundtable. There were several demonstrations in 1989 that were of symbolic importance in the democratic rebirth of Hungary, such as the reinterment of Prime Minister Imre Nagy and his fellow martyrs. The Republic was declared and announced for the third time in the history of Hungary on the 23rd of October 1989, on the 33rd anniversary of the 56th Revolution. The first free elections took place in May 1990, after which the Hungarian Democratic Forum formed the government with József Antal as Prime Minister. The following years were devoted to three main areas: rebuilding democracy, Euro-Atlantic integration, and the transition transforming the society and economy. Hungary joined NATO in 1997 and the European Union in 2004.